You found the perfect image for your responsive site. It looks great on desktop, but loses its awe when viewed on a phone. Between the change in orientation and the smaller screen, all of the fine detail becomes impossible to see. Displaying different images based on device characteristics is called art direction, and the picture element was designed exactly for this. Inside is a list of source tags. Each source tag includes a set of rules and the image to use when those rules are met. You also need to include an image tag. The browser enumerates the list of sources and checks the rules. As soon as it gets a match, it'll use that image. If no source tags are matched, or if picture isn't supported, the browser uses the image tag. Perfect for backwards compatibility. Let's take a look at this in action. The first source tag specifies a media query and checks if the browser width is over 800 pixels. If it is, the full-size image is used. But if the first source tag was not matched, the next one is checked, testing if the browser width is greater than 400 pixels. If it is, the browser will use that image. When the browser width is less than 400 pixels, or the picture element isn't supported, the browser uses the image specified by the image tag. Styling the picture element is done by applying CSS to the image tag, not the picture element itself. This is also where you should specify the alt text and any other attributes that are needed. There you go. You now know how to use the picture element for art direction. The picture element is only supported natively in Chrome 38. But other browser vendors have committed to implementing it. You can use it knowing that you won't break older browsers. Or grab PictureFill, a library for supporting older browsers.